Diva, right? That's her name?
Diva,
Dr. Jill's dog here. She's so beautiful, and she's got her sweet glasses on. Oh, no, okay.
She says, I want them off.
But that might be something people might run into, right? Because there are doggy goggles and cat goggles, but they might be kind of hard to keep on them.
Right. They're hard to keep on, and they're not rated for solar eclipses.
Right.
Which brings up another good point that people are really panicking about their pets, and there really is no need to do that.
Yeah, because you're saying they're smart enough already.
Right. They don't look up at the sun. You know, I usually recommend to bring them in 30 minutes before and keep them in 30 minutes after the eclipse, just in case. But if you have outdoor animals or barn animals, they usually will gravitate inside if there's some sort of circadian rhythm that's off.
Okay, so they have like some sense that something might be coming at them, right?
Right, but they shouldn't really be, there shouldn't be an issue. I've had a lot of people call and say, hey, should we put them on sedatives? Is there something that's gonna upset them?
Yeah.
There really is no need to do that.
Perfect, and you brought some examples though for us to see, just in case people are maybe a little nervous about today, this morning solar eclipse.
Sure, there's all kinds of glasses. I wanna make sure people know, Doggles makes a great pair of glasses, but they're not rated for eclipse.
Right.
But they're great for when they travel in the car or they put their head out the window. And then of course I made my own little eclipse view.
Yes.
Obviously, your pet doesn't need to look into something like that, but you just need to be mindful. It can burn their retinas. They are sensitive, just like people, but keep them indoors and you shouldn't have a problem.
Perfect. And then you also have some calming oils, too, for your pets if they are getting a little anxious.
I think they pick up on our being anxious, so I have some essential oils, Rescue Remedy. Those are great things just to mist around so it keeps you and them calm at the same time, but there really shouldn't be a big ordeal about the eclipse.
Right, and Darren even brought up, because he was saying Chroma Kitty was acting a little weird outside today, they kind of can sense something is going on.
Sure, they sense the energy, they can sense the diurnal rhythms are different, so they may hide, they may go into a dark spot during the eclipse, but again, it shouldn't be an issue as long as they're not looking at the sun, and they're pretty smart not to do that.
Perfect, and what's the worst case scenario, something does happen, what are some signs that you might notice within your pet?
Well, it doesn't happen right away, it's actually sun damage to the retina, but it can happen over time where they go blind or they have eye issues.
Yeah.
But again, really not a big ordeal unless you have like livestock or horses. Just put them in the barn for those 30 minutes before and after just to protect their eyes. Of course, eye conditions are always an emergency, so if you do notice something with your pet, take it to your veterinarian right away.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Dr. Jill.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much, Diva. I'm going to send this on over to you guys, so hopefully Simone Casper is okay, but make sure if you guys want to schedule an appointment with Dr. Jill, check out her website, drjill.com, or give her a call. The number's on your screen. It's 916-989-0733.